hear you, Mazi.
Now then, William. Sorry for disturbing you this early morning, but it is one of those things. This is Mazi Nzurumike, the deputy head of the Directorate of the Indigenous People of Biafra, speaking with us here on Radio Biafra as a service too. But before we go on, Mazi, I would like you to introduce yourself officially, your real name and your position, as I don't have the full details.
Right. Thank you very much. And of course, good early morning from here. My name is Mazi Chukwemeka Nzurumike. I hail from Owerri. I do reside in Germany. I serve the indigenous people of Biafra, the very great people of Biafra, as their servant in the capacity of the deputy head of the Directorate of State. And of course, I want to greet all Biafrans, all listeners from all walks of life. So I want to thank Chukwukika Biama with this very opportunity. And that whatever is going on now, we must remain focused, we must remain resilient. At this point, Mazi, I will give you back the microphone in case you had some follow-ups. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mazi. Without not wasting time, we'll just go straight to the business of the day. I just want you to introduce yourself officially, how people know you, because I just know you with that English name, which I know you don't, you are not comfortable with it. Thank you very much for being part of this program. Mazi, let's look into our struggle at this moment. The main issue now is the court case that is coming up on 21st of this month, and I will say that there is about 8 days to the main event. First of all, let me go in this way. How prepared are we for the main event? For example, when I'm talking of how prepared, there was a broadcast, the head of the directorate, our head, said they refused to present our leader on that day, bringing him out, that we are going to lock Biafra land down for 1 month. We are going to lock it down 1 month, and we have been echoing and comparing on that. Number one question is that, do we still stand on that? Then number two is, because this question is synonymous, that's why I just want to throw it. Also, are we a kind of agreeing with them that is just to bring him out of the court? Maybe take him back. Do our leader have his extraordinary rendition? In other words, he has nothing to do with the zoo court. It's just for them to return him. Why are we emphasizing on bringing him out? And let's say, because definitely they are going to adjourn the court on that day. If we will predict how zoo does it things, they will just adjourn. Let's say, for example, they came out just in order to calm people down and brought him, and also kind of return back and adjourn it to, let's say, January or February. We will continue to be praying and waiting and all those things. Mazi, you have the mic.
Yes, thank you very much. First of all, Chukwuka Biama, continue to protect, preserve our great leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, a wonderful angel from heaven, sent down to defend the very, very great people of Biafra. Everybody has now seen that without our leader, a lot of things could go wrong, especially in the land of Biafra. That politicians are now somehow feel emboldened, doing what they're doing, because they think that the person to somehow checkmate their ways is out of the way. But we're assuring them that he's not out of the way, that the structure of indigenous people of Biafra is built in such a way that the struggle continues. It continues in earnest. We continue to soldier on without any prevarication. And to your question, of course, what our great leader Mazi HOD in the person of Mazi Chikedozim said, it does hold. What he said does hold. What he said is what the people have said. Whatever he pronounced on the Radio Biafra with the holy microphone is what the DOS also do stand for. And I will assure you that, of course, everything he has said remains. If they fail to release our leader unconditionally, and bring him out of the court, and then do the needful. The indigenous people of Biafra will not take this lightly. We are going to forge ahead with whatever we have on our table, all the tools, all the necessary things we need to do. We're going to deploy them, and as simple as that. They must release Onyango Mazinam the Kanu unconditionally. He is not a citizen of the zoo. He doesn't belong there. He belongs to United Kingdom, where he is his citizenry. Does uncle. So he does not belong to the zoo, and therefore the process of his kidnapping must be reversed. It must be reversed, in fact, in such a way that they must also prove the fact that they are remorseful for what they did. They must pay back for what they did. They need to return him, reverse that very evil process that they actually rendered on our leader. That is what we are demanding for at this very point. Mazi, the microphone will go back to you in case I've answered your question, Mazi.
Okay, you have answered it to assure Biafrans and the whole world that indeed we stand on that thing on our table, which our head of the directorate has mentioned, which is we must sit at home for one full month. Biafra land have to lock down. All right, what if in case they now play this game, you know, rumor is flying about, let's say they bring him out and join again, let's say January, because it's always 2-3 months, always 2-3 months. What should we continue with the same action, or is there any other thing? I know that there are many things on your table that may or may not be given to the public now, but in case whatever, if they do this one, do we have a different thing to offer as well? If it is something that is not supposed to say on air, of which you will not say, but it's just to give Biafrans assurance. Mazi,
Biafrans must remain assured at all times and at all places that this very leadership is not going to leave any stone unturned to make sure that this very great leader on earth, not only a great leader in Africa, not only a great leader in this very hemisphere, he is the greatest leader in this universe, if you can agree with me. He must be released. And if they don't do that, we have all the tools, like I said before, on the table. They must take Biafrans very, very seriously at this point, and even in the future. They must take us very seriously. That's all I can say to that. Whatever resources, whatever, you know, alternatives we have, they can be assured that we are blessed with alternatives. We are Biafrans. We are Biafrans. We don't lack. We are not lacking. And we are saying they must release him, as simple as that. That's just a simple thing to do. They have to do that. And if they want peace to reign, of course, and they do that, and then we'll see where we go from there. But definitely Biafrans must be rest assured that this very, very, very movement, this very, very great movement, this very people, hallowed people of Biafrans, are not lacking. We are not lacking, and we do stand up to the occasion, and we are equal to the task. Thank you so much, Mazi.
Thank you very much, Mazi, for that assurance. I believe Biafrans are listening all over the world. Let me ask you this question again on my desk. Some people said that the negotiation is going on between IPOB and the zoo. Is such a thing true, or is it just rumor? I just got it. I just want to throw it to you. If it whatever, you clear it off. And how can negotiation be going on if it is true, and while our leader is still in their dungeon?
You see, whatever we have in terms of, whether it is legal negotiation or order, we have our representatives in that very arena who do have to work on behalf of the indigenous people of Biafra. We have a legal team working assiduously around the clock and ensuring that the needful is done. I wouldn't go into the issue of negotiation for now. It is too premature to come up on air and talk about negotiation when we do have our regular consultations with our legal team working for us, and whenever we come that far in terms of if there's any negotiation, We will make it available to Biafrans. People should not hook on to rumors until it is pronounced on Radio Biafra officially. For now, they should be rest assured that we are represented and that our team are working assiduously around the clock. Thank you very much, Mazi.
Thank you very much, Mazi. The essence of all this thing is to clear all this thing, because these days our people are so much connected to what is called rumor. And I want to ask you another question regarding this rumor. I have received a lot. They said that our leader is no more in the DSS dungeon. He's somewhere, this, that, and all those things. I don't need to mention, go detail into what that voice note said. But in my own understanding, based on how Zoo does their thing, I believe they are the one bringing up all these rumors, maybe in order to do something on 21st, to tell you, to pass the rumor around then for him not to surface on court. I don't know whether you have heard it, but the rumor said that he's no more in the DSS dungeon. I don't know how you can clarify this thought from anyone who have heard it or who will hear it later.
Yes, I will advise Biafrans to avoid all hearsay. Hearsay has done a lot of damage. If not that this struggle is ordained in heaven, we wouldn't be where we are today because of rumors and hearsays and all sort of misleading information out there. That is why our leader beforehand made it clear that your place to receive information, your place to offer your listenership, your place to anchor is on the Radio Biafra International, Radio Biafra as you know it, Radio Biafra London, the very place where Mazi Obilo is operating from, where Alozie operate from, the same place where Mazi Jonathan operate from, all of you that broadcast there. That is where our leader said we should be listening. So any other place you collect any information is just at your own service. I don't know. We don't have anything like that. Our leader is still in the hands of this very evil jihadist. And we are working assiduously, like I said before, following the procedure and trying to make sure placed and quite on time. That's all I can say. There's nothing like he's been placed in any purgatory or whatever you can call it. He is in their hands. They must release him, and that is what it is. Any other thing is just a made up and misleading fabrication. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mazi. Let's come to the issue of our radio. Some people are still talking that our relay stations are not functioning in some part of Biafra. Like somebody wrote me, Bayelsa. He said, is Bayelsa not part of Biafra that the radio is not working there? I don't know the assurance you can give to Biafrans regarding making sure that the process, the things DOS is doing to make sure that within a short time, some all the whole Biafra land will be covered with our relay station.
Great thanks to that very question. Great thanks to the source. I usually dislike identifying Biafran territory by virtue of names, the dog names given by the slave masters. In fact, Biafra, we place the call, Bayelsa is a heartland of Biafra land, and I try to go by names like Udi or wherever it is, whichever area, but otherwise let's just take it the way it is. If we have been working hard to make sure that these relay stations are made available, that it does reach every nooks and cranny where people need them, and from time to time there could be some hitches, there could be technical problems, and whenever they do bump up, what we do is we get the information, and that's why I said thanks to that very source, because when information comes, we use that very information to go straight to the point, find out the area, find out the very vicinity where these radios are not working well, and try to do the necessary repairs or rectification of the very, very apparatus. So whatever we have, whatever they are, if they're not working well, we will revisit the very vicinity and get them rectified. Thank you very much, Mazi.
Thank you very much. Let's come to the issue of the genocide or massacre that took place in Izumbe. So far, I don't know what are the plans on ground. Is it the one that need to be dished out regarding our families over there and how the military have killed our people. I don't know if there's anything you can give to us on air here in order to maybe console the people or tell them that there is something on ground that is coming, because there is no hope from the politicians. I mean in Izombe, the recent killing in Izombe.
Yes, we never had hope in any of these politicians, whoever they are. I still do have my respect for Senator Baribe, the man who stands for his people, and he speaks out. He doesn't speak on behalf of a particular group. He speaks on behalf of his constituency, where he represents, and the entire land where he comes from, and stand like a man. That's what we want normally all those who call themselves representatives to be doing. If all have been doing the same, I'm not sure that this whole carnage would have gotten to this very, very level. But because the so-called intellectuals, because the evil governments, especially the so-called people who say that they sit on the seat of power, where security is in their hands, normally supposed to be in their hand, these very evil governors have lost it all. They have lost it all, because sometimes you can say, okay, a politician as they are, as corrupt as they are, as we know them to be, that they could wanna, steal, but somehow have a limitation of what they can do and what they cannot do, what they can allow and what they cannot allow. For them to have allowed the uncircumcised pedophiles, in the name of jihadists, descending our land, castrating our people, destroying lives and properties, decimating our people, obliterating lives at all levels, at all demography, including the children, including the babies, including pregnant women, including youths. We heard it from a commander on the field saying, kill anything that you see. What does he mean by kill anything that you see? Is it not recently that we heard from their spokesman of the army that said nobody should panic, that the people will be roaming about in our land? And how come the voting now shifted from don't panic into killing field, into genocide? Why are these governors not doing anything? Why are they there, for Christ's sake? And we are going to say only one simple thing: that they have lost it all and that they should wait for their own turn. As simple as that. We can't be raging the lives of people, rendering them useless, now turning our land into the land of a refugee. You could see our people carrying their baggages on their head, a picture we have never seen for decades, and now reappearing courtesy of these stupid governors, courtesy of these very evil doers sitting there serving their mustard of the Fulani Caliphate. They are only there, they are sent there, they have been posted there to only serve their masters. They are blind, they don't even know where they come from no more. If you ask them their names, they can't even tell you their names anymore. They have forgotten it all. All of them are Musa Musa. They are there, and we're going to tell them that place does not belong to them no more. They should vacate our land. They shouldn't be governors no more. We don't need them anymore. If they are there, and even worse than the Fulani people we are talking about, they are even the worst enemies we have than Fulani as we speak today. These are these so-called governors. They are there running carnage. They are there running genocidal war against our people, because they are the ones that invited them. It was not just only Python 1, it was Python 2, it was 3, it was 4. Now they are calling it whatever oppression, the damn peace, or whatever damn trouble. And these are courtesy of these very governors. They invited all this nonsense. We cannot forget him all. We cannot forget Abba's massacre. We cannot forget Iwacha massacre. Everywhere, massacre. Since this idiot Fulani came to power, since they started reigning on that very seat, we only knew Mbakwe as the last governor that made any sense. We knew Michael Opara of those days as last politician that made sense. Any of them that came afterwards have been going from fire to fire. That's what I've been seeing here. And we are saying today is enough is enough. But Biafrans must be assured. Biafrans, you must be assured that we are leaving no stone unturned to come back to stand up and to claim our land. Our land is our land. We are going nowhere. The land belongs to us. We know they are clearing fields, they are clearing vicinities, they are clearing places
for the Aruga. That's what they have come for. They did not come for any roaming about of our towns and our cities. They came to clear the land for Aruga. If the ESN could not allow the Fulani herdsmen to do it, they send down their soldiers to come and do it. That's what is going on. That's the truth of the matter. They want to clear our land for the Aruga. And we have a Ebonyi State governor who today, as we speak, is part of the committee of Aruga. The so-called Aruga project they have officially was announced by the federal government as a committee member. And now people should not wonder why he is taking the stance he is taking, the stand he is taking against his own people, selling out our land because of what he thinks he's going to get from his slave master. And this attitude, this servitude they are displaying are actually, you know, going down not well for our people. This is at the detriment of our people. This is not going well for us. This is only, you know, eradicating the whole livelihood in our land. And the only thing we can do is to forge ahead, come together, all of us, all walks of life, clergies, all the traders, all the transporters, all of you and all walks of life in the Afro land. We must understand we are all affected. Nobody is exempted from this very carnage. Nobody is exempted from all these atrocities. All of us together. And therefore, when it is said on Radio Biafra, the next step to take, all of us will fall in line. We are going to take that next step. We have our HOD at any point in time will come on air and tell us the way forward. And all you have to do is to remain very much alert, remain attentive, to listen to Radio Biafra and listen to the next step of action. But be rest assured that we cannot vacate our land. Those carrying their luggages on their head, they must return back to the land of their people. They must come back to the land of ancestors. That land is not the land of Fulani. You cannot ransack our villages and our towns and killing our babies and our women and our youth and asking us to leave our land only for the Fulani to come occupy. No. Whatever bullets you have, we are going to march it on. And as simple as that, our people must remain hopeful. The land is for us. The land is not for the enemies. It's not for the governors. Any governor that feels this, he has no other way out, should pack and go to Zungeru. We should pack and go to Zungeru and leave our land for us. Thank you very much, Mazi.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mazi. Still on this issue of Izumbe, connecting to the potential one, I call it potential because that is how it comes, that is about to happen in Opala community. As I just read in the ending of my broadcast, that such a thing is about to happen. Even the military themselves, we are warning the community indigenous that if they continue to chase the Fulani herdsmen, because what happens, I don't know whether you have read the story, but let me recap. People, Fulani took their cow to their farm, and the people revolted against it, pushed them. On the process, a Fulani boy stabbed an indigenous of Opala. And there was a problem there, definitely they have to react. On before they say within few minutes, the military land in commando dress. They were as the news we are sent to us in our death. They're dressed in commando and they begin to warn the indigenous. If you don't want, using Izumbe as an example, as a reference, if you don't want such to happen, don't attack the Fulani. Why the Fulanis are bringing cow in their land? But I thought that the open grazing had been cancelled. So we see that politicians are not ready to do anything. I don't know whether this Opala is in Imo or is in Abia, because the two governors are still the same thing. But what I'm throwing to you, Mazi, how prepared are we in case if this one is about to happen? Because we will not keep quiet and be watching what happened in Izumbe, maybe to repeat itself in Opala. Because people have to fight. You can't go to farm after under the sun, under the rain, and all the toiling, nobody assisted you, an idiot from somewhere bring cattle and come to destroy it, and you ask the people to keep quiet, definitely they will revolt and definitely they will bring in the army. How prepared are we in case, as they have used Izumbe as a reference?
Yes, Mazi, this very fresh case is one other disturbing incoming turbulence, and should be also tackled as such. I will only say that we are doing our best. You see, they started by trying to destabilize this very movement. They started to see whether they can somehow reduce the effect of ESN by sending those dissent
to come and cause some headaches. But I can assure you that ESN is intact. for that, they are going to do the needful. They are going to do the needful wherever they can render their services. It is very disturbing that these people have gone this far, that the, even what they sent down, the so-called troops they sent down, were to come and enforce Ruger. They are in our land to enforce Ruger, and not even because of just the election. They are there to enforce Ruger. That's what they are doing. That's why you see them in those areas, in those localities where there is much more prospect for Ruger. And I don't know which governors are responsible for that very in the fresh area now marked out, whether it is Hopeless or Zorinjo. The one that has come to serve his masters perfectly well, the useful tool of the Fulani Caliphate, or whether it is the other governor. What they are trying to do is to use these soldiers, these very marauding soldiers, to effect what they are looking for. But be assured that we are, whatever frontier we found any challenges, we are going to do our best to make sure that we'll fight it off the way possible. I cannot tell you what plans we have in this very fresh case. We are going to study it. We are going to see what is there, and then come up with the effective strategy. That's what I can say. There's nothing on the table in terms of how to fight off the enemy that has to be dissected on air, of course not. But one thing is sure, we must defend our land. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for that intelligent answer. It's just to strengthen our people to know that indeed it's not going to be as usual or as they think, but as for us, that we are prepared. Thank you very much for that. And Mazi, I want to ask this question regarding the 21st court case. How, first of all, we thank our women for the protest they did in UK. It was wonderful, and we hope for such to be coming up, because apart from the legal teams, we need to be showing other ones. Like a place like Europe, how prepared are we to flood entire, maybe wherever, with protests on that day? And also, I am asking regarding, based on the experience we had on 2016 thereabout, when such a thing happened, there was a kind of, I don't know, a protest that took place. Is it in Brussels, in Belgium, where they are headquarters of UN or thereabout, all the whole Biafrans camp there? Is there anything like that? I know that COVID is part of the things that factors that are militating it not to, but I believe it's reducing. Do we have anything like that on board? But for 21st, is there anything like such a protest that to let the world know, so that the people will say, why are they protesting? And they will tell them that there is something going on in the zoo, so that the eyes of people will go there. I don't know if there is any preparation of such.
Yes, Mazi, you see, our people in Biafra land must remain, indoors when it comes to things like that, because we want lives and properties to remain preserved. And those of them in diaspora, of course, it is expected that much actions are put out on the streets. It is expected that continental reps have taken this very, very monumental task upon themselves to ensure that all countries, wherever they are in their jurisdiction, are really gearing towards making sure that they have an effective protest on that day in the streets of the countries where their protections are very much guaranteed. And so that is the expectation. Sure, we must make sure that wherever, even COVID, laws are getting weaker. The laws, the grip on the freedom of movement are getting quite easier. we expect that all those countries begin to now fall out on the streets and demonstrate very heavily and very much with vigor, ensuring that the public, wherever they are, do understand what is going on in our land, do understand the very evil being perpetrated by the present jihadist government of the zoo, and let them understand what's happening. So we are going to do that. It's our tradition to ensure that these kind of presentations are done wherever we are, and that is what I do expect is going to happen. Yes, Mazi, that is supposed to happen. All continental reps, they have this on their table. It's an agenda. They have to make sure that all countries within their jurisdiction do organize themselves for that very day. That is the least we can do in diaspora. That is something we must do. It is upon our own shoulder to carry this very load. It is not a heavy load this time around. We are used to going out and demonstrating in diaspora, and we don't have any hurdle apart from COVID. But like I said, many countries, the freedom of gathering are already being made easy, and that is what we expect every continental rep to ensure that is being done in their jurisdiction. Thank you very much, Mazi. Definitely, that is what we do look up to.
Thank you very much, Mazi. Now let's come to Anambra election. What is our stake on that? That's how I will throw it directly to you for more analysis.
On the issue of Anambra election, we, the indigenous people of Biafra, officially have not come up with a pronouncement on air. If you ask me, we do wish what should happen instead of election should be referendum. These governors should be busy asking for referendum. They should understand the reality. It's not enough having all the monies and billions of dollars stealing from the people, rendering the lives of people totally useless, helpless, that people now don't have even, I'm sure people are going about the bushes looking for lizard. And they might not say it. It is disgraceful. It's uneasy. It is embarrassing to come and tell you what they are eating. This is the level of poverty. This is the level I will tell you, evil we have descended in. This is the hell on earth we're talking about. And these governors are pretending as if these things are not happening. People have fallen flat when it comes to poverty. I know the Fulani jihadists have been doing that strategically. They weakened our businesses, they weakened our economy, they attacked Ibeto, they attacked anybody that raises up with any business, they attacked his business. That's what they've been doing. But then what happens, what about the governors? What about the allocations? What about the billions of money sent to them? What are they doing with that? So it still boils down to, on their own court. It boils down on their own court to the job of protecting the lives and properties still boils down on their own court. They have to do that. They have to carry it out, and they are the ones causing these very problems. And so the Anambra election is such a sensitive one, of course, that the pronouncement will come up, of course, about where we stand finally, because many things are involved strategically. We all know we don't want that election. Nobody wants it. Nobody from the leadership wants it. Nobody from, I know Biafran. I wonder any Biafran that says he wants that election. What we want these morons to do, I say morons because it's just what it is. Just the simple truth. The truth is bitter. Any human being will act differently from what these people are doing. You act differently from what they act like a human being and not like an animal, isn't it? So, but we have a situation where the so-called leaders, if we can go and hire baboons and monkeys, I'm sure they'll perform better. By all indications, they will perform better. But we have it because even a baboon will try the best. As some animals can be greedy, fine.
But at the end of the day, when they are satisfied, they leave the rest. Go and look at lion, the male lion. You come, you pack the whole thing, and when he's satisfied, he leaves the rest for the other ones to eat. The same thing with the baboons. When they are satisfied, they leave the so-called alpha male. When they finish, they leave the rest for the others to eat. But we call these ones human beings. They will take everything. They will eat and get satisfied. Their generations will be satisfied. And they will still pack the rest and pack it away. Instead of leaving it for the people, they pack it to Iboland and bank it up there. And what kind of human beings are these? So, in a nutshell, we don't believe in that election. As simple as that. And the right pronunciation will come at the time it will come. We don't believe in it. We believe in a referendum at this very point. This very point, the right thing to do is referendum. Because that is just the simple reality. The reality is that we have been rejected in this very experiment called Nigeria. And it's been long we have been rejected. We have been rejected in all. I don't have to start spelling out it all. Is it about the monies that have been borrowing? They count us out. Is it about the projects they have been carrying out? And instead of them to build any railway for you, they take you to Niger Republic, where Buhari comes from. Buhari is not from Nigeria. Everybody knows that. Only his mother is from Nigeria. His father is from Niger. That's why he's developing Niger. That's why he's building refineries for Niger. Because when he retires, he's going back to where he comes from. He'll be visiting his mother's home, of course. So what they're doing is developing their other places in other countries and leaving us where we come from. And the same resources from our backyard, is from Abia State, where you call Abia State, is from the Ogoniland, is from Abuleri. It is from Imo. It is from where you have a River State as well. So all these places are the ones producing the resources these people are lavishing. And upon that, they go and borrow, and they're pulling on the head of everybody. That's why they're doing it. If it is only on the head of Fulani people, they will not do that. But they know that they're borrowing on the head of everybody. Even when the countries are now departed, now when the nations are parted from Nigeria, at the end of the day, there could be an arrangement where everybody has to pay his own quota to settle the bill. So they are borrowing and telling us we're not part of it. But later they want to come and tell us we're part of it. We remember the palliative, where they went and borrowed and got a whole lot of things, both donations from the international community. They said, oh, those of you from Southeast, you are not part of it. They'll tell you boldly, they'll just tell you open, with every impunity. And you have these so-called politicians who cannot stand on a pulpit and speak out. Nobody said you should go and stand now, have a fist fight or anything. Take up that microphone, group yourself together, have one voice, and condemn something. They will kill our women, they will rape them, nothing will happen. Nobody will say anything. But the worst of it all is that to let the enemies, let us try to somehow revenge a little bit. Your so-called politicians will now find their mouth. They will now find their energy. That will be the time they know that there is a microphone to talk. Only how to attack the people. In Igbo language, you say, Onyemere Anyifa. Who did this thing to us? Who, Onyemere? Who did this thing? We keep on asking and we don't know. I can only tell you maybe the devil alone. But they themselves will now see as the angels of the devil themselves. Thank you, Mazi.
Thank you, Mazi. Thank you very much for your stake on this Anambra election. I know it's very, very sensitive, and there are a lot of things may not be time to air it. I want to, before I will ask the audience maybe one or two questions before I leave you, I would like to ask this question to you again. Before our leader was kidnapped, there was this agreement between us and the Ambazonians. How effective is the DOS who are in charge of IPOB now? Are we maintaining that relationship with Ambazonia till now?
Yes, Mazi, the people of Ambazonia much more our relatives. Yeah, I would say integral part of Biafra land. We are naturally related, as simple as that, and we are
we have forged up a natural relationship based on our ancestral evidence and also genetical. And everything that you knew about our alliance remains intact. Everything remains intact. We continue to work together. We continue to have each other's back because the more friends you have, the better. That is what I can say to that. We must forge ahead together. Thank you very much, Mazo, on that very front.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Before you go, to round it up after an hour, let me see if I will get one or two questions from the audience that are listening. In case you are listening, you want to call or you want to text on the only number you can get me now is 614.